Welcome to General Anatomy and Physiology at Western Technical College. I am your instructor, Isaiah Foster, and today we're going to be navigating through your Blackboard site as well as review the syllabus and the policies for this course. There is a small syllabus quiz that is due after watching this video, and I'll show you where you can find that as well. The first thing I want you to do, though, this is your home page for Blackboard. If you go down to the syllabus and schedule here, I want you to go ahead and pull up the syllabus along with the lecture schedule. We're going to be covering this, and then afterwards we'll go and navigate through Blackboard to give you an idea of what to expect here. I am going to start with the syllabus right here, and we'll go ahead and grab it right here. We'll open it up. And we'll start with the very beginning here. So this is some logistical information, some contact information. My name, Isaiah Foster. My email address, my office number. My office hours do vary term to term. Once we get going in the fall term, I will set those office hours. And the fastest way to communicate with me is by email, as of course I do check that frequently. Our start date is Tuesday, September 3rd, and our end date is Thursday, December 12th. So just make sure that you come prepared the very first day. We are going to actually begin the teaching process, if you will, and there will probably more than likely be some homework given out as well, so just be mindful of that. Our meeting times are Tuesday and Thursday for 60 minutes. They are face-to-face, and the lecture is held in K408, which is on the fourth floor of the CUM building. And then, being this is a blended course, you do have 60 minutes of online video and assignments that you need to be working on. The labs are all face-to-face, and it depends on what section you signed up for, depends on what day and time you would actually appear for those labs. You only have lab one day out of the week, and it's about 2 hours and 10 minutes. The labs are held on Mondays and Wednesdays in room K402. With this being said, if you were scheduled to have a lab on a Monday, Labor Day Monday, being we don't have labs, we have one of two options for you. One is to attend another lab throughout the week. We have many different labs, so you can be face-to-face with myself or another instructor is fine. The lab is very universal, being that you will get all the same information. Just people just teach it just a little differently. But we can't say that with the lecture portion, so this only kind of works for the lab. But the lab also, if you can't make one of the other alternative labs, that's fine. I do have a video of me teaching the lab, and I can certainly pass that off for those that are missing Monday Labor Day. So please contact me and let me know. Course information, General Anatomy and Physiology, gives you a little course description there. We got some prerequisites, which obviously you would need to meet in order to be in here. We have some textbooks here that are required, and a big one right here is the Mastering AMP Access Card. In order to do your homework, you do have to have this access card that usually comes with the book. I am completely fine with you purchasing a hardcover book, a paper, loose paperback, or the online version is fine too. But the biggest thing is that you get this Mastering AMP standalone access card as well. Learning supplies. It says webcam and microphone. You don't need this. This is a blended course, not fully online. I do not require webcams or microphones for the online portion, so you can kind of ignore this here. Course competencies here. These are the things that I'm going to be teaching you throughout the semester here. We do have a grading policy. Now, I do apologize with making the syllabus. They would not let me go back and switch this, but we have two grading scales, if you will. They're both the same. With the grading scale of a C or better, 70% is what you need to achieve or better in order to count towards your program. Anything a D or an F will not count towards your program, so just kind of be mindful of that as we get going here. Also, blended delivery, so just make sure that you have a working computer, you have good internet service. There are no excuses for not being able to accomplish your blended or online material, and the biggest thing is obviously have that access card as well. So you can complete your homework assignment and watch the videos. So you can kind of read a little bit of that. It's pretty much pretty straightforward with that. Retake and makeup policy. So each student may take a maximum of 2 independent, not with the class, unit lecture exams. So mindful, lecture, not lab, just lecture exams. Each student will receive 1 makeup and 1 retake. Now there is a difference between a makeup and a retake. A makeup is, let's say you were sick one day and we had a test and you couldn't make it. You could use your makeup for that and not be docked any points whatsoever. A retake, though, is where you took you actually took the exam and you scored poorly on it. And so when that happens, if you got less than 70%, you would be able to have the option of retaking one of your lecture exams. And when you do retake, you can earn up to an 80% on that retake exam. The score earned on the retest or the retake exam will replace the original, whether it's better or worse. So that's something to keep in mind if you need to use that. A makeup exam, though, you can earn all the way up to 100% on a makeup exam. So you have a makeup, you have a retake. They are two totally different things depending on the situation. And you do have a 2 weeks to take that. Now, anything after 2 weeks, you're not able to take that. Now, a lab, you do not get a retake at all. You do have an option of a makeup. So if you were scheduled for a lab on a Monday and you needed to come in or you were sick and you couldn't make it, you could attend one of our other labs. We obviously only want you to do this under emergency situations, and you do have to get approval by the instructor. But if you were to need to retake an exam, you need to contact my lab assistant, Deacon Stanek, and here's his email and his phone number, and he would be able to schedule you for the lab makeup. You only get 1 lab makeup, and you do need to make that up within 1 week of time, not 2 weeks like the lecture exams. Any late assignments or extra credit policy, I do usually dock you half the points for a late assignments unless noted otherwise. There are no extra credit assignments, if you will. I do have some extra credit questions on the exams, though. Attendance is very crucial. I think everybody would realize that being in attendance is very important, and missing any of those would obviously set you back a little bit in the class, and then trying to cover. And this is a really rather difficult class, so you know it's really hard to kind of pick up where we left off sometimes. So you know, attendance is very, very important. And occasionally we do have some in-class assignments where if you do not attend, or if you're not in class, you will not be able to make those up. Student responsibilities: attend and be on time, prepare for all lectures, make sure you're printing out the PowerPoints, very, very important, so you continue to take notes while you're in class. Contact me whenever you're having difficulty. Take all assignments on time, see the makeup policy, abide by the Western Student Policy, and have an active email account. If I need to get a hold of you, this is one of the ways that I usually use. Lecture lab cancellations: if there's a cancellation, I will try to email everybody. I will also put it on our Blackboard, and then it's also noted outside of our division office located in the Coleman Building, C100 as well. Lecture and lab rules: please turn off all cell phones, pagers, things like that. Absolutely no text messaging allowed during class. If I do see you text messaging, that's considered a disruption, and you will lose 5 points from your overall grade every time. We're only in class for 1 hour, so if you can't last an hour, then maybe you should think about what your priorities are. But try to concentrate on this material. It's rather difficult. So assessment: once you start a lecture exam or quiz or lab practical, you may not leave the testing site. If for some reason you have to leave, I have to take your exam and you will get scored whatever you left with. Any disruption as far as student code of conduct will be dismissal from the class under reduction in class grade. Course repeat policy: if this is your second time for general A&P, if you fail your second time, you do need to meet with the Dean of Health and Public Safety, and at that time he will make a decision on whether or not you can re-enroll for a third time. If this is your first time and for some reason you fail, you will be able to re-enroll back into general A&P, although we do really highly encourage this foundation of A&P, what we call prep for A&P class. If you're really struggling with the class, this is a good foundation class. It's something to consider if you haven't considered that. We do have some openings in that as well. This is just talking about alternative learning guidelines. So again, the blended part in here. We do have some academic integrity policy, just making sure that everything is fair and honest and intellectual environment for both faculty, students, and staff. We we obviously, of course, absolutely frown on cheating, plagiarism, falsification, other forms of dishonor, or unethical behavior. And you can see here that we kind of list some of these academic dishonest definitions here for you. And if you are caught doing one of those things, we do deal with it at a course level with me. And then I would forward it on to the college level, as you can see here, where there may be more strict consequences, if you will. Western student withdrawal policy here. I do not withdraw you from the course. If you decide that you no longer want to attend for whatever reason and you do not withdraw, unfortunately I'm left with giving you whatever grade you are left with, so just be mindful of that. Western's attendance, non-emergent excused absence. So at times people need to have some mandatory reasons for being excused from the class: for religious observations, military service, jury duty, participation in college-sponsored events, so on and so forth. We understand that. If you do have a disability and you need more time on an exam or quite space to do that, you do need to contact Chris Falansby in the academic or the disability services, and her phone number is listed right here. I cannot give you any extra time or quite space unless you do contact them to be approved. Western is a tobacco-free policy, so no tobacco used indoors or around the campus. And that is a really quick summary of your syllabus here. I want to go over to our Blackboard site here. We're going to go at our very home page right here. So this is probably where you saw the video. Obviously, the video is not up right now. I do have a video here on how to access the Pearson Mastery and AMP card. So once you get the actual card, this should walk you through how to link it with the Pearson and the access card. And I do make weekly announcements for what to expect the following week, so you guys understand what's to be expected in both lecture and lab per week. In the assignment tab right here, these are all the different units that we will actually be covering. So you don't see all of these right now, obviously. I only launch them when we get closer to being done with one unit. So after we get closer to being done with unit one, I'll open unit two, and so on and so forth. We do have the state learning objectives right here. This is that syllabus quiz, so it's a 6 or 7 point quiz that's due by September 8th by midnight. So after you're done watching this video, go ahead, pop that open, ask the questions, and it's part of your grade. And then you can start taking a look at Unit 1 here. If we go in here, we have the online material, so this being that it's the blended portion right there, and then you have your in-class stuff. So the in-class PowerPoints will start there. These are the PowerPoints I want you to print off and bring to class with you, and we will start with orientation right away on our first day. So just be mindful of that. If we go back to online, you will see here we'll have a PowerPoint and a video link, and you want to watch this on orientation. And then the same thing with chemistry. There's a little PowerPoint and video to watch that. And then after you're done, you will take this Mastering AMP assignment right here. This will launch you into Pearson. So once you do that, it will launch you over there. You'll answer some questions. Now, I just want you to be aware, when you do the assignments, it will grade you over in Pearson, but it will take a little while for the grades to be transported over into the Blackboard gradebook, because Pearson and the Blackboard are not running off of the same server. So it does take a little bit of time. I mean, like sometimes hours, sometimes a day. So just be mindful of that, of your score to transfer over correctly into the Blackboard gradebook. But eventually it will. I can also do a manual refresh on that, and I usually do that after the unit is done. So just kind of be mindful of that. So that's kind of what you want to do for that. And then, you know, once we get closer to being ready to take this exam, I'll open up our next unit, and this unit here will go away. It will disappear. So that's kind of your assignments and kind of what to expect here. And once we get rolling, it's pretty much the same thing over and over again. So some additional supplements here. I have some diagrams. I have some lab microscopic images. I have some interactive websites here with videos and some testing things. These are sometimes good for lecture, but then a lot of them are really good for labs. So when we get into these different lab subject matters here, you can print off these pictures and label them. I think that's really helpful. Contact information. So we have our quick contact links all right here, and I'll be putting mine in here as well. You have your syllabus and schedule. So obviously this is where we found our syllabus, and this is our lecture schedule. Now the lab schedule isn't quite available yet. You will get that the first day of lab though, and I will also post it here once it does become available. So by the time you're probably watching this video, you may see it, may not. But let's look at the lecture schedule here. So if we go, this is our tentative lecture schedule. So that could change depending on any situations. I know like Last winter, we had all those days off because of the polar vortex, so we had to really mess with the schedule quite a bit, but in the fall, it's usually not that big of a deal. So we don't have any classes on Monday because of Labor Day. We start our lecture on Tuesday, though, and we'll start right into orientation. And over here, you can see what would be expected in class for exams, quizzes, or assignments. Now, I don't post the assignments in here just because it does kind of change a little bit. But I can tell you will get an assignment your first week for sure, maybe even your first day. That will be due. And here is your online materials right here. So you have your syllabus quiz, and then you have your orientation chemistry Pearson assignment that we reviewed a moment ago. So we'll do this Tuesday, Thursday. Next week we'll continue Tuesday, and you'll have your first exam on Thursday, as you can see in parentheses, which is on orientation and chemistry. And about every 2 weeks, as you can see here, we have an exam on the subsequent units. And then we get down to the second half here, and it gets a little quicker, a little busier. The units aren't as long, so they come a little faster. They're only about a week and week and a half, if you will, apart at times. And we do have a couple online exams that are completely open book, open note on the lymphatic and immune and the digestive system. We do have a couple days off for Thanksgiving, Thursday and Friday. And we do have our very last exam, our very last day. There is no final exam in here at all, so you guys can thank me later. but there is no final exam, so no midterm, no final exam, just exams throughout the year. One thing I want you to make, I want to make mention of, very, very important though, all lecture exams include the material from the online material that you learn for that unit and the face-to-face material that you learned for that unit. So just be mindful. It is both. You're not just doing the online stuff and forgetting about it. You're actually being tested in class on it as well for the final or one of or the, for the unit exam, like you see right here. So just be mindful of that. Okay. So with that being said, we'll go back over here, and really that kind of summarizes everything. The first day, we'll just do a roll call. We'll just do a little intro of me and who I am, and then a little intro of you and who you are, and then we'll get started with the material. So please make sure you have your PowerPoints printed off. That's very important. I can't stress that enough, so that you're completely ready for this course. So, but I look forward to meeting and working with all of you. It's going to be a fun, but yet really fast 15 weeks. It's going to be go very, very quickly. So thanks everyone. If you have any questions, let me know. And again, just a reminder, if you have our schedule for your lab on a Monday, you either need to get a video from me or try to attend another lab throughout the week. That's completely your choice. Just let me know though what your plan is. Thanks everybody. Take care.